like to ask Kenny, I'm just curious where he's sitting.
Mommy coming home with Danielle, stopped to chat with Marianne. Hello.
Hi, Daddy.
Hi, Danielle. Who's that? Huh? Hello.
Hi.
Hi. Were you a good girl at the store? Did you stop at the store with Mommy? What? Did you drop Kenny off at his dance and leave Kenny at the school?
No.
Yeah, we did.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's at a big dinner dance, huh?
No.
Yeah. Okay, we'll go in.
Congratulations to you.
June 8th, 1990.
Oh. I have it on it.
All ready to go?
Go ahead. Go ahead.
You excited?
Bye.
Yeah.
He's off to his graduation.
I have to go in the house and get my film. He said there's no film in it.
Danielle, wait, Ken, stop.
That's a roll of film, isn't it?
Where?
What's this thing?
Look at Daddy.
Hi, Danielle.
Hey. Look at Daddy.
Look at you, sir. Hi. Hi.
Ah, she just turned her head.
Good girl. Oh, well.
How about just Kenny and Mommy now? Come here, Danielle.
Okay.
Come here.
Okay.
Here, Danielle, Bubba.
Let's see Grammy. Hi, Grammy.
Oh.
Carl, want me to take one of the three of you?
Yep.
Yeah.
She's got a
crush
on
her.
No,
they don't.
Thank
you. That's normal.
Honey,
you're on camera.
Oh.
I'll do that.
She's
that.
Okay, smile, Ken.
Just say cheese.
Cheese. Look at me, Ken.
Yo, man. I am standing
Come
next
here.
To him.
Come on.
Okay, look at me. Smile, Kenny. Got it.
Okay.
Hi, Sue.
Sure.
Oh, that's what you need back there, right?
Yep. Hold up.
Papa.
Sorry, you have a hat on.
Look at Daddy. Pop-Pop.
Go ahead, go.
Here we go.
Thank you. harmony, and oneness. These qualities of special strength have been instilled in us over the years at Sacred Heart School. We have been fortified with God's grace and will stay close to our loving Savior and form a personal relationship with Him in daily prayer. Unity among school, church, and God will sustain us as we travel on life's road. We realize we cannot succeed alone. We need our families, friends, classmates, but most of all, the loving care of God, our Heavenly Father, to strengthen and bind us together in Christian harmony. We have completed the first step to our preparation for life. We have changed from the frightened, curious children who entered kindergarten to the confident, well-informed young adults who are ready for high school. This change will not happen without help, much help, help from God who created us, our parents who nurtured us, and our teachers who instructed us. They are the reasons why we stand here tonight. They deserve the credit for whatever success we have had or will have. In the name of the graduates, I welcome them and all of you tonight. There are many reasons why we are grateful to you, our dear parents. You make great sacrifices necessary to send us to a Catholic school. We know the one hope you had was that we would be prepared intellectually, physically, socially, and especially morally to take our place on the stage of life. We want you to know that we will do our best. With God's help and continued care, we will not fail. To our pastor, Father Hirsch, our priest, our principal, Sister Ann Monica, our dedicated sisters and teachers, we offer our sincere thanks for the interest shown in each one of us. We promise we will do our utmost to make you proud of the class of 1990. To all of you, our families and friends, who have honored us with your presence this evening, we are grateful. This occasion has an added luster and importance because you are here. We thank you and God bless you. Once more, on behalf of the class of 1990, I welcome you. Please stand for the opening hymn.
Thank you. Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Amen.
Brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our Savior.
Paul to Timothy. He who lives, he who tries to live for Christ will be persecuted. You have followed closely my teaching and my conduct. You have observed my resolution, fidelity, patience, love, and endurance through persecutions and sufferings at Antioch, Iconium, and Lystra. You know what persecutions I have had to bear, and you know how the Lord saved me from them all. Anyone who wants to live a godly life in Christ Jesus can expect to be persecuted. But all the while, evil men and charlatans will go from bad to worse, deceiving others, themselves, you, for your part, must remain faithful to what you have learned and believed, because you know who your teachers were. Likewise, from your infancy, you have known the sacred scriptures, the source of the wisdom which through faith in Jesus Christ leads to salvation. All scripture is inspired by God and is useful for teaching, for reproof, correction, and training in holiness, so that the man of God may be fully competent and equipped for every good work. This is the word of the Lord.
Praise to your heavenly Father. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus.
the fellow who's standing in the back there, I recognize him. Would you just go out and close the front door so all the air conditioning doesn't leave at one time? Thank you. Well, it seems kind of strange. 19 years ago, I was sitting in these same chairs and experiencing graduation from here. But I have a little bit closer experience with Sacred Heart, as most of the graduates here will know. 8 years ago, I taught school here and was privileged to have these children as first graders. Most of you came in all wide-eyed and nervous, little crybaby-ish, you know, the first few days of school, being separated from mommy for a whole day instead of just a half a day like kindergarten. But there was really something great about that. You know, you came in and you were going to school with the big kids, and you had two teachers, well, one for each classroom, if I remember correctly. And you came in and you started a whole new beginning, the beginning of your education here at Sacred Heart. Some of you have been here for the whole 8 years, and I congratulate you on making it through all 8 years. You know, when you come into a new situation, the first thing you try to do is learn about what's going to be expected of you. You learn a little bit about what the environment's going to be like and what it's going to take to survive, to flourish, to get through. Sacred Heart has provided, I believe, very strongly, a good environment for you young men and women to grow up in, a good environment for you to learn, a good environment for you to understand and come to know what it means to be a Christian in today's society, what it means to be a follower of Christ. Now, over the years, there's been a number of different changes. One of the most notable changes is that you got a new principal a year or two ago. So the guard did change a little bit. Have different teachers over the years. We still have the same pope that was present when you started school. You still have the same pastor. And maybe some of you still have the same friends. So there's things that have changed and there's things that have stayed the same. The first reading that we had today, which was read very well, I might add, calls us to remember part of the reading. It said, remember what you've learned, remember your teachers. Remember what they've told you about your faith, about your life, and just what it means. The lessons that we've learned at Sacred Heart. Sure, there's reading and writing and social studies and arithmetic, but also they're all tied in with under a bigger umbrella of a Christian life. There's religion class, but all through, your teachers have been trying to impart to you or share with you an understanding of what a life is that's tied in with faith in Jesus. The theme that you've chosen this year is unity. In the beginning, the young lady who was up here welcomed us and talked a little bit about that unity. It's a oneness. It's a togetherness. It's a grouping of people, and they're bound together by a common cause. Something there has caused all of you who come from all different parts, different families, something has caused you to be identified as one. It's not just the fact that you're in the same class, but I think on a bigger scale, it's because we all share the same faith. We all share the faith in Jesus Christ, and that's the reason you're here. It would have been a lot easier for your parents to send you to a public school. They wouldn't have to sacrifice as much. There wouldn't be so many bills to pay. But your parents wanted, in a very special way, to give you an education, which, as the young lady said in the beginning, helps to mold you into competent young men and women ready for high school. And I pray that's what you really are. I hope you're understanding that you are young men and women now. You're prepared to go on into high school.
Brethren, this evening we come together as the members of God's family to praise Him for His goodness to each one of us. Let us pray with fervent hearts. The response this evening is, Lord, hear our prayer. Thank you. this day, Lord God of all creation, through your goodness, we have this wine to offer, through the vine that we're to be to become our spiritual
drink. Let's begin our prayer.
Let God, we ask you to receive us with pleased sacrifice we offer you with humble and contrite hearts. Lord, wash away my people. Brothers and sisters, pray that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God the Almighty God. Lord, look on the heart of Christ your Son, filled with love for us. Because of his love, accept our Eucharist and forgive our sins. Grant this through Christ our Lord. Lord, be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
Father, our powerful and ever-living God, we dwell always and everywhere to give thanks. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, lifted high on the cross, Christ gave his life for us. So much did he love us. From his wounded side, so blood and water, found from sacramental life in the church. To his open heart, the Savior invites all men to a warm and joy, spring to salvation. Now with all the saints and angels, we pray to you for it.
Sacrifice which has made our peace with you advance the peace and salvation of all the world.
strengthen in faith and love your pilgrim church on earth. The servant Pope John Paul, our bishops John and Edward, and all the bishops, with the clergy and the entire people your son has gained for you. Father, hear the prayers of this family you have gathered here before you. Mercy and love unite all your children, wherever they may be. Welcome into your kingdom, our departed brothers and sisters, and all who have left this world in your friendship. We hope to enjoy forever the vision of your glory through Christ our Lord, from whom all good things come.
Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Thank you. Thank you.
Would only the graduates please stand? I'm wrong. Sit back down. My first mistake.
Go in peace.
Stephanie Allen, Eric Scott Blom, Leslie Joan Bates, Alea Marie Bucks, Ian Scott Bucks, Theodore William Cabot, Nicole Citrino, James F. Connors, Jill E. Davidson, Joseph F. DiPaolo, Tamika Nicole Domino, Melissa Ann Dias, Scott David Fifield, Michael Joseph Friese, Mario A. Gonzalez, Henry Carl Gossett, Robert Thomas Harrigan Jr., Peter R. Jensen, Jennifer Erin Jubin, Karen Eileen Yerkowitz, Clint K. Keene, Scott Michael Kelleher, Jessica Marie Klitz, Suzanne Elizabeth Cornis, Nancy Lee Cook, Sean Edward Langford, Walter Joseph Maluchnik, Susan Marie Mamrath, Tanika Sharon Matthews, Elizabeth Naomi Morin, Daniel L. Nelson, Stacy Lynn Newman, Patricia Michelle Hunt O'Neill, Robert K. Oro Jr., Tara Christine Pasca, Nicole Ann Pierce, Francis Puccino, Charmy R. Qualls, Amy Lynn Rachel, Alicia Michelle Riley, Linda Maritza Rubiano, Henry Joseph Schneider, Michael A. Sheets, David Vincent Snyder, Sherilyn Taggart, Rachel Marie Tolman, Kenneth Philip Thompson, David T. Tyndall, William Vega, William S. Vega, Cheryl Ann Ward, Jennifer J. Williams, Kathleen M. Yadlowski, Amy Sarah Zaremba, Carrie Ann Zwift,
thank you. No. Up here? No. Get up there.
Thank you.
sponsored by Senator Bill Bradley of New Jersey. Kathleen Yadlowski was first place winner, Amy Strenza second place winner, and Cheryl Ward third place winner in the USA competition.
Ceremony, the reception hall will be as follows. The students will
few years ago, I would have said, my dear children, grew up in a hurry. This morning, I think you thought I might eat you for breakfast, didn't you? However, I'm not all bad. We had to get you ready for tonight. A bride, the groom, often has pre-nuptial jitters. You had pre-graduation jitters. It was my job to settle you down. You did a beautiful job, fantastic job, and I'm very, very proud of you. I said something this morning, maybe when you saw my sharpened teeth, you didn't pay attention, so I'll say it again. They're not teeth, but fangs. I'll say it again. You are welcome at Sacred Heart anytime. We will try our best to help you, to advise you. You are more welcome than your parents. And if I don't have time for them, I'll have time for you. And many times, young men and ladies have come back, many, many times, for advice. We're always here to help you. It's your parents, it's your school, it's your father. Badiato feels the same. I'm sure Father Schaefer, our distinguished guest, feels the same as you catch him. Your parents have worked very hard to get you this far. The teachers, we all have. But everybody forgets you. You've worked pretty hard to get here, too. If you don't, they're not only diplomas yet. I still have something over them. Those are blank folders, but their diplomas are over there because it's too much confusion to straighten out in here. You deserve that diploma. You have that diploma because you've worked for it. Make no mistake about that. You better keep working. You know, television has been filled lately with Gorbachev, Mr. Gorbachev, and President Gorbachev, rather than President Bush, and other world leaders. They were sitting where you are sitting now. I had a couple of Saturdays ago, I had a funeral mass at 11, and a wedding mass at 2. Was the funeral mass the ending? Or the beginning of eternal life? The wedding, was it the ending of single life? Yes, but the beginning of a married life. This is the ending of your career at Sacred Heart. It's the beginning of a new career. Every point in life is a beginning and an ending. Sometimes an ending before a beginning. And you are going to be part of this world that we all are trying so hard to run now. And you will be the leaders in some years. We may have senators here, and we may have governors here. I mean, we may have a president on this side. I don't know. I'd like to think so. We may have doctors, nurses, lawyers. Work, work. Keep your sense of humor. Keep your smile. Work hard, but don't take yourself too seriously, okay? Take everything seriously except yourself. Learn to laugh at yourself. Smile at yourself. Remember, God is always with you. The moment you were baptized, God entered you. He said, we will take up our abode in you. God is living in each one of us by His Holy Spirit. God will always be with us. So ask God for the help you need when the going gets rough. But the best advice I can give you is laugh at yourself, smile at yourself, and work hard. Maybe it's better to say it the way St. Bernard said, work as if everything depends upon you, and pray as if everything depends upon God. God bless you. Thank you. We are proud of you.
We wish to thank Sister Thelma, who helped to coordinate and prepare us for this special graduation commencement. Sister, we are grateful for the time given to this occasion, but mainly the love and understanding you bestowed upon us this past week. God bless you. Thank our principal, Sister Ann Monica, in the name of the graduates of Sacred Heart School. We have been fortunate this past year to have her as our leader, advisor, and teacher. Sister showed a good general interest in our schoolwork and shared our many fine achievements with the rest of the school. We promise and hope to continue with the high standards and ideals presented to us here at Sacred Heart. Sister Ann Monica, we thank you and God bless you from the class of 1990. To our dear parents, we take this opportunity to give heartfelt thanks to our parents, whose tireless efforts and steadfast support have helped us to reach this day of happiness. This commencement is our first step toward a new beginning and a greater responsibility. The environment of our homes and our Catholic school has enabled us to appreciate solid values that will be with us for the rest of our lives. You allow us the privilege of excellent training in a good school. For this,
Hello, Walt.
Turn around also and shoot
that one. Hi, Scott. Hi, Henry. Cool hand, Luke. Hey, you missed, Luke.
Why knock this ball out? What? Shut up.
I can't get that tennis.
You're solid. Oh, someone knocks out my shot. Thanks a lot.
He's a goldfish. Don't you believe my dad doesn't go? Alright, you're gonna have.
Hi, Mommy.
Okay. Hi, Daddy.
She's Miss Crab today. Look at Daddy. Say hi.
Hello, Christy.
Hi.
Let's see this pretty cake.
What is that?
It's piano and
keyboard.
You
want to
make cake pretty? Yeah. Hello, Aunt Gloria. Hi, Gammy. Hi, Grandma.
Hi.
Happy graduation. Graduation. Tomorrow the world. There are these professional ball players out here.
You got it on?
Oh, yeah. And look at these professional ball players out there.
They haven't played my girl yet, huh?
What is it?
That's why we want to find it. Where is it?
Oh. Look it up, man.
Yeah.
Oh, good.
Oh, look at it. A car thing.
It's a limited edition.
Carl, you'll appreciate that.
Isn't that big?
It's a 57 Chevy.
That's a Chevy.
Oh.
Isn't that nice?
Yeah. There's a 57 Chevy.
It's a telephone.
Joey's here.
Pretty sharp.
Look, Carl.
Hi, Joey.
Oh, okay.
That's not very last William.
Oh, yeah.
on, man.
They go all the way around here, all the way up to 7th and 8th grade.
They're growing older.
Well, you don't know half right.
How many of you guys are in them? Are any of you using them? You are?
Look at my freeze eye.
There's a kid with an afro. There's Rob, man.
Sandwiches.
Hey, don't call.
Papaloy salmon.
Oh, you saw the smoke.
Salmon.
Oh, I'm seeing signal coming in.
I was on my back for about 3 hours.
You are an operation.
I have faith in you.
Hi, Chris. Hi.
As long as you have a couple beers before the operation,
that's
so
all. That's the anesthesia.
Tomorrow night, doubleheader, twilighter. You can't go? Who are you going to take?
I don't know.
Kenny for his graduation.
Teresa.
You took her picture away, didn't you?
Huh?
You took her picture away, didn't you?
So what? I got close up now. Mama and daughter. Hi, Teresa. Hi, baby. Hey, baby.
But your mind has got to be always on that, or forget it. You'll never do it. You
know what I mean?
You
got
to be that type of person.
My mother.
You know, I couldn't do that.
You are playing softball.
My mother had a fire.
Your first instinct is to put it out. You know.
My mother had a fire down in the basement. Remember the old
basement? Yeah.
Well, down in that basement, you remember how we used to have the kitchen down there?
Mm-hmm.
Well, she had a fire there. It's like in the basement, we had a kitchen. Well, we were friendly with this Jewish guy in the grocery store across the street.
What's up, bro?
And he knew lawyers and shit like that. So we called.
Steph. Yo, Steph, get a homer. Wendy's turn. When's Nicole bat? When you bat, Nicole?
I can throw this ball 100 miles an hour now. Bet me.
I'll bet you. Lying.
No, I'm not.
You're lying now.
No,
you cannot throw that ball 100 miles out.
I bet you I could.
All right, we're going to go. We're going to find out.
Okay. Oh, shit. You got that on camera, right?
Back up.
Cal time at the Thompson residence.
Ah, you got behind you over here.
What did you supposed to tell me?
Well,
they have
sold it.
It's hard.
You know what he's trying to buy?
Well, he sold the Jeep dealership, but he's got the state buying the property.
I'll tell you the name.
It's like for offices or something. There's a big show dealer.
I think he sells the land to the state.
Oh,
a living wage.
But the only problem is he has to have a partner.
Even if it's only
and he'll be liable unless he gets the partner, satisfies the partner before he goes into Patterson. So he's got a year to deal with that.
Not even like a,
I told them, but I said it's a bad time for anybody to try and start a dealership. I don't care how good you are.
Well, you think this plan started with dinosaurs and amphibians?
If you notice some
Teresa, Teresa, hey Teresa,
that Dr. Leakey and all that.
That shit is a foul.
Hey,
yo. They don't resemble each other.
You know, we had to do a wedding.
That's my boss.
Your boss?
Why ain't gorilla still turning into human beings?
Which one's your boss? Oh, is that your boss?
And the more he's mine.
We just had a reorganization.
Oh, did you?
A reorganization.
I know, it's kind of deal with me.
That's it.
I thought he was going to hire Randy. I'm waiting for him to call him up. And yours, my God, you wash it so much, Chrissy says it's going to rust as much as you rust it.
Yeah, you're going to wash the paint right off it.
Yeah,
Randy, didn't you know you only
Randy could do tops, Vic.
Hey, I take pride.
My kids are out of school next week.
It's my day.
Monday, I'll babysit.
Usually it's 1:30.
She's going to play ball.
Tuesday, 7:30.
Nikki, not Nancy.
Then I come home.
Girls want to play ball?
Here, I'll open that.
Thursday I work 10 to 3 and I come home about 4:00. I'd rather it that way. I want my days long.
Just like it's back to life.
Then Friday I'm off.
It'll pass.
Come on in.
I like it.
seen him, I told him,
Not so hard.
Am I doing it too hard?
Yeah.
Well, so you should have, yeah.